You go when you're ready.
Hi guys and welcome. Together we are Kingpin Productions, made up of Harry Dalzell, Lee Baston, Rico Malloy and me, Will Hobson. Today we are going to be pitching to you our idea for our upcoming music video in the hope that you believe in us and our concept to produce the best music video possible. Here's the pitch pad that we're referencing throughout the presentation.
Thank you very much.
We have created many previous media productions before as a company that we are proud of. Two of which are the short films that we have created, Abandoned and House of Decay. We feel that these pieces of work reflect what we are as a company, so enjoy these short films.
So the song that we decided to go with and would allow us to kind of elaborate our creative vision is Helpline by Muramasa, a British recording artist who's currently signed to Interscope Records, which is a subsidiary of Universal Music Group. The artist features singer-songwriter Tom Tripp, who's also signed to the same record label, so it'll be a lot easier when we try and request basically permission. The song itself is a fast-tempoed alternative dance song, and it's about Tom Tripp's love interest, Gina, and how his alcohol habits have basically made him oblivious and cause him to have alcoholic-induced blackouts. And the song is essentially him trying to recall what he's basically trying to express to his love interest. We felt as a group that this song would be a very relatable song to use as, again, it's kind of relating to like drinking too much, like young people drinking too much and kind of having regrets or trying to think of what they did to the previous night. As it's like, yeah, a common experience for younger people. So the actual concept of the video is going to be an interpretation of the lyrics. We felt that the lyrics are very kind of overt and very clear. So we felt that doing like an interpretation of it will kind of help visually depict what's going on a lot better. So we thought this would be like the best approach. We also thought that this would be kind of like a testing like a platform for us to kind of elaborate our ideas, because initially we kind of were struggling to think of any ideas, so we felt going off the actual song's lyrics will kind of help us expand that even further. The actual style of the narrative as well is going to be non-linear, so it's not, these shots are not going to be in chronological order. When it's on about basically Tom's love interest, it's going to be basically cutting back and forth to when he was actually with his love interest and then when he's singing about his love interest. To go over the kind of the narrative again, briefly, it's basically about a teenage boy's broken relationship and how he's subsequently fallen into a drinking habit. The video reflects back to him expressing all of that. The style that I've been over, we're basically going to be showing that mainly through the effects and the techniques that we're going to be incorporating in our video. That's going to help establish the kind of style that we're going for. So for example, one effect we're going to be predominantly using is a VHS like retro effect throughout the video. That's going to help kind of show when the video is being shot in like the past, and it also kind of again helps visually reflect the style of the song, because the style itself is an alternative dance song, so we felt having this alternative visual style would help kind of bring that back. But yeah, the effects will be elaborated on in the inspiration slide.
Our creative vision is made with neon lights, the city at night time, and the car park at night time. The neon lights, this concept adds a modern day spin to the video and allows the visual to not appear too gritty and professional. The abandoned looking car park we feel is quite relatable and not, makes the visuals not look too sleek, and this fits with the genre which is alternative R&B. We want to display this with visuals, which is more immersive. As a group, we looked into numerous music videos that were the same genre as ours. We felt this would help us build a concept that we'd enjoy making, but also the target audience would enjoy too. The first music video that we looked at was Reggie Snow, Medley Roots. This music video was created by a company who follow the same style of work as us, and we feel that the raw locations and the VHS effects is something we feel as a combination works really well, and we'd like to improve this into our aesthetic too. Another music video we looked at is, which inspired us, was the music video for a song called Drink Ham Something by a Korean artist, Yeji. The music video captures the city of Seoul at night. The main aspect of this video that inspires us was the visual aesthetic used. The majority of the video includes shots of people and characters in front and around shops of neon lights. We felt this gave a sleek, vibrant look to the visuals without the use of artificial lighting. This aspect is going to be the main focus within our visuals of our music video.
Another piece of inspiration that we got was from the indie band Jaws and their song Be Slowly, which featured a very similar concept to our visual style. They've used a retro VHS effect, which is what we're going to be going for in our music video. And as you can see, their aim for the music video was a 1990s vibe, which again, we too are going to be using, and it's evident in their clothing. The final piece of inspiration came from a genre that is completely different to Jaws, and that is Korean rap. This music video stood out to us because of the after effects that have been added in post-production, as you can see. The video incorporates a lot of frame-by-frame animations that have been masked on top of the original footage. These effects are what we are going to be primarily using in our music video, and we're going to show them in our sneak preview at the end of our pitch. We hope that having a well-laid-out Gantt chart like we do will instill your confidence in us. And the reason for us using one is so that we are completely organised and will allow our creative ideas to become a reality. Instead of having a vague list of tasks for the stages of production, I've decided to break it down into the tiny details so that we can tick each item off before when it has been completed. So far this method has worked well with me as we have met every deadline that we have had so far. The Gantt chart has and will continue to help us spread the workload across the four of us so that everyone contributes evenly to reach our end goal of creating a high quality music video. We were aware that some of our shots would take a lot of time and the process of editing is long, so we've put a week of contingency, as you can see in your pitch pack, after the 2 weeks off for Christmas. We had not planned to do any work during that break, so if we were behind, we would have time to complete our work to the high standard without running over the deadline.
As you can see on pages 7 to 9 of the pitch pack, we have completed 1 minute of our music video through storyboarding. We are currently in the process of completing this for the whole of our music video. As you can see, we've ensured that our storyboard is completed neat and well presented to avoid any confusion when filming and ensure that filming is done accurately and no footage is left behind. Some shots within the storyboard may appear offensive to some audiences, for example, the gunshot to the head. We've overcame this and created a more light-hearted effect by using After Effects and making it more animated and cartoon-like. Therefore, the imagery we want to get across and the point we want to get across is still there, that we're not offending anybody. Our shot list coincides perfectly with our storyboard. This is vital to avoid confusion when filming. We have organised our shot list into locations, so all shots within one location are filmed at one time. So this is going to save us a lot of time when filming, and we're absolutely sure we're going to meet the deadline.
Locations. Here are some of the key locations that we've picked out for our music video. We've selected these locations based on the feel and aesthetic that was determined from pre-production documents such as mood boards and brainstorms. We know we wanted the locations to be quite grungy due to the alternative genre of the song. That's why we've picked out locations like the alleyway, the clock tower and the car park. Starting on page 11 of your pitch pack, you can find all of the location scouting documents. As you can see, we've listed down many different aspects of each location, such as the strengths, weaknesses, availabilities, and other general comments such as the facilities that it has. For example, if it's got running water, heat, and yeah. The backup locations have still been completed to the highest quality with all of the same checks done for them. Although we don't need permission, as it's on public property, we've still informed the council of our plans to film our production out of courtesy. Health and safety. Health and safety is something we take very seriously, not only with this project, but all the projects that we do. It's part of our company ethos to have the safest working environment on and off location. If you turn to page 19 on your pitch pack, you'll be able to see the risk assessments. We've meticulously gone through each location and identified all of the possible risks. When we have found the risk, we put control measures in place to either stop the risk from happening or greatly reduce the chance of it occurring. We want everyone involved in our filming to have a safe and enjoyable time. This is achieved through the use of these documents and good practices when we're actually filming. After completing the risk assessment, I decided whether that location was suitable for filming in or not, as I'm the head of health and safety for Kingpin Productions. I've had to make the decision to not include a location that the directors wanted to film at in this project, which was the abandoned factory, as the risk associated with it were too high, as there was lots of sheer drops, clutter and glass. That's why we've never had any accidents on previous projects, and we will carry that track record over not only in this project, but projects we do after this.
Even though we are working as a team to create the music video, we all have separate important roles within production. I should be doing two roles, and I will be the director and the lead performer. We chose me as the director, as I am the lead performer, and I know what I'm comfortable with doing in front of the camera. Will Hobson is going to be the camera operator, as he has a wealth of experience with a Nikon D3300 DSLR, so it will be beneficial for overall production for him to take the lead on this task. As he previously said, he is the head of health and safety for the company, so we felt it was only right for him to, again, take the reins with this task. Enrico has the most technical skills out of the group, as he has been using the editing software Adobe Cloud for many years and knows how to create professional edits, which is why he is going to take the responsibility for being the prominent video editor for this task. His responsibility is to ensure that the music video is glossy and sleek throughout editing. The final role is distributing the music video, and that goes to Neve Ashton. This means that she must upload the video to the platform YouTube while ensuring that it isn't violating copyright laws. She will also be the assistant director to me, so will help me in directing the visual aim for the music video. We will obtain our equipment by booking it out through the Loughborough College booking system, where we will gain permission to use it for our production. We will give the various pieces of equipment back to the college either before or on the deadline so that we do not violate the protocol.
So when basically developing ideas for our music video, we thought basically characters that we need to get for various kind of aspects of pre-production and filming the video, to basically ensure that we don't fall into any kind of legal disputes, and we thought ethically it would just be a big like considerate part of the whole production as we're starting up as a professional company. One of the main clearances, if you'd like to have a look on page 26 to 28, was for actually gaining rights to the song, as I previously stated. The singer-songwriter Muramasa, and singer-songwriter Tom Tripp are both signed to Interscope Records, again a subsidiary of Universal Music Group. Saying that, we basically wanted to ensure that it was completely okay to use the song in full for the whole video, for uploading it as well and redistributing it. So we felt that it would be kind of important to produce like a letter requesting song permission. Basically, to summarise, though, it was basically just a request access to using the song for non-profit, and in return, give both the artist and the record label full credit for use. Another clearance that we needed to consider was locations. So, as previously stated again, through the concept of our video, we were thinking of having certain scenes take place in like a house party and other various locations in town as well. Filming in town is okay because it's, well, out to the public, so we're allowed to film. There's no laws stating that we're not allowed to film in public. But one thing that we really need to consider was obviously filming in someone's private property for the house party. So saying that, we also produced a letter requesting permission to film in that said location that we do choose out, that is still yet to be kind of discussed. And it's essentially just giving us full permission to have the interior of the house in the film, and to have that film said distributed as well. Concluding clearances, we also created an actual release form. Now this we felt wasn't the most necessary form, purely for the fact that we've already kind of assembled our group and who's basically going to be included in the film, and they've already given their full consent. But again, starting up as a professional production company, we felt that this would still be, you know, something ethical that we should have included anyway, in case anyone said was featured in our video that we didn't initially decide to include. So essentially it's just there so they can sign it to say that they're okay having their face on film, and to again have that distributed.
As you can see on the screen by the images, the style of costume we've gone for has been heavily influenced by the 90s era. We felt that this era of fashion coincides perfectly with the VHS effect we want to use. We feel that certain aspects of this era of fashion are making their way back into society, and the youth are really picking up on this. We felt that due to our target audience being late teens to teenage years, we felt that this specific style would allow us to be relatable to them.
Throughout the process of deciding what song we were going to use and what our concept was going to be, we faced a few issues with decision making. We as a group overcame these minor matters by having structured meetings where we would discuss what our approach should be in creating a professional music video. We had one meeting where we changed our song of choice to the current song Helpline, which we liaised with you, the client, to see if you agreed with our decision, which thankfully you did. We felt that these meetings really helped to solidify our concept and create a really healthy working team environment so that we could all produce our best work. We used them as foundations for building on our idea until it was confirmed. As you can see in the last page of your pitch pack, we have provided evidence of these meetings and what they discussed.
Now we've almost reached the end of our presentation, so now we have a kind of a little sneak preview of our upcoming video. This is mainly formed from test footage, so it's not the actual footage that we're going to be using in our final production, but it was kind of used there as a platform to test out all the effects that we said we're going to incorporate and the techniques. So we hope you enjoy the video and thank you for listening.
Well, that brings us to the end of our presentation. We at Kingpin Productions thank you very much for listening to us, and we hope that you make the right decision in choosing us for your music video production. Thank you. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them.
Thank you. Very good. You were just over on time, but it was fine. You're like a minute over, but it was very detailed though, really.
Indeed.
You kind of covered everything you needed to and more, so very well done. I don't really know if I have to.
I don't have any questions, to be honest.
I have to say, your persuasive language was excellent. You really sold yourself as a company, so that was really good. I haven't got any questions.
Oh, okay.
So, really well done.
I've broken up.